name is Dr. Alexander Shtilbans, and I'm a neurologist specializing in movement disorders. I've been with HSS since 2011, and I'm involved in clinical research and clinical care of patients with various movement disorders. I treat all movement disorders, and the most common one being essential tremor, and second most common is Parkinson disease. But I also treat dystonias, different spasms of the face, and all abnormal movements overall. Clinical trial is the process to evaluate the safety and effectiveness of a new medication. Without it, we would never be able to know whether medication is working or not. And there are three phases of clinical trials that exist in the world. Phase one is dedicated to evaluate the safety of the new medication. Phase two evaluates the appropriate doses of the medication. And phase three is designed to really find out if there is a statistical significant efficacy that medication in question has over placebo. And the gold standard for clinical research is to use placebo, which is like sugar pill that folks have to take, some part of the participants have to take, so the examiner can compare. I'm very excited to announce that there is a new medication for Parkinson's disease was approved last week. It's called Crexont, C-R-E-X-O-N-T. Crexont is designed to last longer than conventional immediate-release carbidopa-levodopa, and it's helpful for those for whom regular carbidopa-levodopa only lasts maybe an hour or 2 hours, and they have to take it five times a day, seven times a day. Crexont can be taken 2 to 3 times a day, and it lasts throughout the day. Crexont can be used for anyone who suffers from Parkinson's disease, but it would be especially useful for those who are not doing well on the existing immediate-release carbidopa-levodopa, as it doesn't last as long as needed. Crexont is a carbidopa-levodopa just formulated in a way that it lasts longer, so the side effects would be identical to the conventional carbidopa-levodopa, and that could include nausea, dizziness, drops of blood pressure, sleepiness. I always advise my patients to ask questions me directly. Those who are not my patients should ask their movement disorder neurologist for sure, but the reliable sources of information in movement disorders and specifically Parkinson's disease are Michael J. Fox Foundation and American Parkinson's Disease Foundation, where folks can actually find very accurate, pertinent information. But overall, at the end, it still would be general and to know for sure whether certain medication would be appropriate for individual patient, they need to ask their doctor.